If anywhere deserves the brochure cliché, a tropical paradise, it surely has to be the Seychelles. They're 1,000 miles from anywhere, sprinkled across the Indian Ocean, halfway between Africa and India. Of the 110 islands, the largest is Mahé. Over 100,000 people from all over the world come to the Seychelles every year, and the vast majority stay in big hotels like this on a standard package holiday. But with an increasing number of guest houses and self-catering apartments around the islands, more and more holidaymakers are travelling independently and making their own arrangements. How easy is it to do it yourself? And is it any cheaper? Right on Mahé's lovely Beauvallon Bay, I found Le Petit Village, 7 spacious and well-designed apartments. The Seychelles is one of the world's most expensive holiday destinations, but self-catering helps keep costs down.
It's your turn to be waited on now, Abdul. Oh, thank you.
Families who run guest houses and apartments are only too happy to pass on insiders' advice on things to see and do. But for the first couple of days, most of us just want to crash out. You'll find plenty of good local restaurants if you can't be bothered to cook. And for a treat, try the Bagatelle, set in 5 acres of landscape gardens. Well, this restaurant specialises in seafood and Creole cooking, and Creole dishes use lots of aromatic spices and herbs, all grown on the islands. This is Sea and Surf, it's red snapper and island prawns. Victoria is the only town in the Seychelles and one of the world's smallest capitals. Looks familiar? It's Little Ben, a tiny hand-wound replica of its big brother in London. It looks down the high street, where you'll find the tourist board and most of the island's main travel agencies.
You should obviously do some homework before you leave home. And the Seychelles Tourist Board in London will send you an impressive amount of brochures. And you should definitely book at least 2 nights accommodation in advance, because it would be terrible to come halfway across the world and then find you'd nowhere to stay.
A local travel agent should be the independent traveller's first stop. They can give you personal advice, help you budget, and surprisingly, it's often cheaper booking hotels through them than direct. So, armed with the information I need, where better to map out an itinerary than the Pirate's Arms, Victoria's main watering hole and meeting place? I'll certainly be booking a trip to one of the Seychelles' remoter islands. But first, let's hit the road and explore Mahé. A mini-moke is the coolest way of getting about. The roads are pretty good and you drive on the left. First stop, the gallery of Michael Adams, the Seychelles' best-known artist. He paints the richness of local life, and his inspiration is all around him. The Seychelles are unique, the only mid-ocean granite islands in the world.
It's these massive granite boulders that make the landscape, and especially the beaches here on the Seychelles, different from other tropical islands.
When you're driving around the island, you might be lucky enough to see a giant tortoise like this one, because lots of hotels have them as pets. They can live up to 200 years old. This one is 97, but there's life in the old tortoise yet, I can tell you. Now, self-catering means shopping. You'll feel quite safe at Victoria's friendly market.
No idea what that is at all.
In fact, anything that looks familiar is probably imported and therefore very expensive.
You pay 25 rupees for this cabbage, that's just about £3, whereas you can have all this for the same money, including the splendid papaya and the passion fruit.
After the break, I go island hopping. And John Carter's in a reborn city, that's Dresden. A popular excursion from Mahé takes you to nearby Round Island. You can experience the coral reefs without even getting your feet wet through the windows of a semi-submersible.
Now I know what a goldfish feels like. I'm in the tank.
The protected reefs of the St. Anne Marine National Park teem with scores of different fish. The day out includes time for snorkeling and lunch on Round Island, where they serve up tender tuna steaks and delicious aubergine fritters in an idyllic setting. And after the meal, there's time to pad around the beaches. Now for that other coral island I planned to visit. Isolated Des Roches is an hour's flight from Mahé. Travelling in small planes adds to the excitement and the expectation of island hopping. No arrival lounge here, but from the airstrip a corridor takes you straight into the only hotel, where a drink of coconut milk refreshes all new guests. The standard of accommodation at Des Roches Lodge Resort is high. It compares well to bed and breakfast rates on other islands, which average around £70 a night for two. There are no proper roads on Des Roches, but you can cycle along tracks through the shady coconut groves. The resident population is just 15 people, and cycling through the tiny village and farmyard brings you to beautiful beaches. There's always one to yourself.
Lots of lovely sunshine today, and it's in the high 80s. But it does rain most of the year, usually in short, sharp bursts. The wettest season, though, is from November to February. Strangely enough, that's when it's most expensive to come here.
Seychelles may seem expensive compared to, say, Britain, but it depends what you're getting in exchange for your money. Here, the location and the service is very special. It's a lovely place, and I think it's value for money.
Two, three, yeah.
Scuba diving is rated highly throughout the Seychelles, and on Des Roches there's qualified instruction with introductory one-day courses for beginners. If you can swim, you can snorkel and still see the wonders of the underwater world. It's a dawn start for some big game fishing and a rod-bending exercise that reels in first a small bonito tuna and then a huge sailfish. So finally, what's the verdict on making your own holiday arrangements?
Travelling independently as opposed to on a package, you get the more remote locations where there are fewer people that hopefully are less spoilt and more interesting.
This is our first trip to the Seychelles, and we chose the Seychelles because we wanted somewhere warm and sunny and somewhere that was quiet and where we could relax. And it has definitely lived up to our expectations.
No holiday here is cheap, and in fact the more islands you visit the more expensive it becomes. But to stay in one hotel on one island for the whole time is a complete waste. It really would be tragic to do that, and you wouldn't get value for money. Individually, these islands are really quite special.
Now, the cost of getting to the Seychelles. Prices fluctuate depending on season and airline, but until the end of June, the Air Seychelles return fare to Mahé is £475 from Manchester, £499 from Gatwick.